Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced course. In today's lecture, we will talk about the reactive forms. Reactive forms in Angular provide a model-driven approach to handling form inputs whose values change over time. Reactive forms are more robust, they are more scalable, reusable, and testable. If we talk about the building blocks of the reactive forms, then we have form control, form group, form array, and form builder. Now, what is form control? Form control is a class in Angular that is used to track the value and validation status of an individual form control. It corresponds to an HTML form control such as an input select text area. Next is form group. Form group is a key building block in Angular's reactive form system. It's a class that allows us to group and manage multiple form control instances. Next is form array. Form array is a class in Angular that aggregates form control or form group instances into an array. It's ideal for managing a collection of form controls and especially useful when the number of controls needed is unknown or dynamic. Next, there is form builder. Form builder is a syntactic sugar provided by Angular for creating instance of form control, form group, or form array. It simplifies the creation of complex forms. Now we will create our reactive form for this HTML page in which we will have first name, last name, email, and contact. Now if we analyze this page, then we will have four form controls and one form group which will group these all the form controls. So currently we are going to implement only two properties of reactive forms. One is form control and second is form group. Now let's implement it. And this is our plain HTML form which we are going to convert into our reactive form. And for that, first I'm going in a file app.module.ts. And here I need to import reactive form module. Next, what we need to do, we need to go our app.component.ts file and we will create our form group of student. And for that, student is equal to new form group, and inside this form group I will create four form controls. Next, we need to bind this form with our HTML file, and in our form tag, I need to write form group, and then I need to pass the name of my form group, and that is student. Now in this form group, I need to write my form control name. And our first form control name was first name. Then we need to write last name, email, and contact form control name. These names of form control names are representing our form which we have created in our TS file. First name, last name, email, and contact. And now our HTML file is binded with our TS form. Next, we need to write our submit button. And on click of that button, I will display all the values of my form on the front end. And on this click, I will call a function print. Next, we need to write our print function. This.result equal json.stringify, so that all our values display on the front end in JSON form. And for the sake of testing, I'm going to display the value of this variable this.result, which holding all the values of the form. Now let's run the application. Now I'm going to pass the values John, week, email, and contact. Let's submit it. As you can see, it's showing all the values of our form, and we implemented this form with our reactive form. Hope you understand this basic example of reactive form. Next, if we talk about the pros of the reactive form, then first is it's predictable and consistent. Reactive forms are synchronous and therefore more predictable. Each state change happens immediately. Second is they are more powerful. They are more flexible and offer more functionalities than template-driven forms, like dynamic form generation and form array handling. Third is testability. Reactive forms are easier to unit test because you are working with an explicit data model. Fourth is immutability. Reactive forms ensure immutability by always returning a new state. And the last one is scalability. Reactive forms are better for handling complex large-scale forms due to their explicit code-based nature. Then if we talk about the cons of the reactive forms, then first is verbose and complex. Reactive forms require a lot of boilerplate code. They might be too complex and heavy for simple forms. Second is deep learning curve. Understanding of reactive forms and reactive programming concepts may be challenging for the beginners. Third is less declarative. The logic of reactive forms is defined in the component class, not the template. And last is extra package size. The reactive forms module adds to the overall size of your application bundle. And this was the today's lecture. Hope you understand the reactive forms. If you have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But if this lecture is helpful for you, then guys, please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.